Alrighty, so from our previous video, I had my thumb messed up a little bit. That's because when I deleted my history, I kind of deleted all of these skin clusters all at the same time. So be really, really careful not to delete your skin clusters, guys. Just make sure you're using delete non-deformer history, okay? So delete all by type, non-deformer history. That will get rid of all those little UV mapping problems or those UV actions, and you will still maintain your skin clusters. So sometimes we mess up with these little problems, so we just got to make sure we watch out for those things. Okay, we're going to move on to the next part of our model, and that is going to be, let's see what we'll move on to. We can move on to the feet actually, because the feet's actually quite simple again. And you can already imagine this is a horrible UV map, so we're going to have to fix this. As always, we begin by selecting mesh, go to your planar mapping, and just put a very quick planar map just to start off with something. And I'm just going to roughly UV that out, move it to the side, and let's take a look and see what we can do with this. Now we've got skin, so down the bottom we've got the feet that will be a different texture altogether. So we're going to make the most obvious cut from this and start with just slicing those edges for the feet. Respective UV texture editor. There we go. Much better. Okay, so let's select that edge loop right there. Shift select that edge loop again. Just make sure it's all selected. And then I'm going to make a cut. Select the UVs and I'm going to move them down. Okay, for the time being. Right, the pants. We need to. I just want to take a look at my. I think it's just a very flat blue color. So the pants, what we could do is make a slice in the center. So, and then separate both sides. That's one way of going about that. Actually, we might actually do that because it's the most obvious place to begin. I'm going to make that slice there, cut it apart, and we're going to move it aside. Right, so what can we do with this? Well, the most obvious place to start slicing is the center, just the seam in the very, just on the inside of the feet there. And then on the outside, well, you can paint your own threads, but I'm just going to keep this really simple and begin selecting that edge loop right there. It's looking good. Just be careful of some poles. That's because we've added some extra little segments there. So it's going to the feet. I want to deselect the feet, and then I'm going to make another cut. And then we'll do the UV unfold again and just select an edge and then take a look and see what the computer comes up with. And it doesn't look too bad, actually. Computer's figured it out quite well. Okay, so this is the front. No, sorry, this is the left, this is the right. Now, what I want to do is try and simplify this a little bit. We've got quite a few things sort of just hanging around, and one ways I can simplify it is merging some of those edges together. And I'm going to merge only those top two because I want to see what the computer comes up with if I unfold. Sometimes the computer can't really do that, which is okay. But I'm looking at this and I'm thinking to myself, okay, the computer's not going to get any better than that. So that's all right, we'll leave that as it is. So that's the foot. What I'm going to do is move that down here. Now we're going to move on to the feet. Now the feet, again, we have more complex segments, and one of the reasons is because we've got the toes here, and also some of these weird little edges that we've got to just watch out for. So one of the things I'm going to do, and guys, by the way, in case you were wondering, this is actually a very, very bad mesh, and I mean, a couple of reasons for that, because I just got lazy or procrastinating with some of those segments. I'm just going to delete some of those edges there. This is actually a bad topology. So for something like this, it's actually very difficult to UV map. But what we can do is split this up into a few pieces. We can have just the bottom soles of the feet as a separate shell. So what I will do is just double-click those edge loops, if they are any, which they usually are. And some of the edge loops aren't that good. It's definitely not the best topology for our character. But for something like this, it's a sort of a minor problem because it's not visible. but it is going to make UV texture mapping a little bit tricky, and that's one reason why we want to be very careful with our modeling, because any mistake you carry down from your modeling, it doesn't get better down the track. It gets much worse. So just select all those edges on that bottom sole of the feet. Okay. Just trying to be very careful not to select anything else. I mean, one of the best ways of working is if you're doing little menial tasks like this, it's not too rudimentary, it's quite simple. Go ahead and, I don't know, listen to some music and work. That's how I would work in general. So I'm unfolding that, and there we go, those are the soles of our feet. Again, the sizes are different. That's because the computer can't, with one Versi, you can't always figure that out, so I'm just going to separate them. Now I've got the top here, and the place where I'm going to cut the next seam is the back heel. Okay, so just the back heel. Let's make sure I stop. Oh, I think I've selected the wrong one. Actually, the inner heel. Let's do the inner heel. Deselect anything that it's accidentally grabbed, and then make a cut there. And this is going to turn out really bad, but I'm going to unfold it anyway. So selecting that, I will just unfold and see what it comes up with, and yeah, it's horrible. And that's because the toes are interrupting a lot of that UV mapping. So what I will do is do the same with the fingers. I'm going to split those toes apart, separate them from the main mesh. You can sew these back anytime, but we need to bring it out so that we can work. We've got something that's easy to work with. Yep, looking good. So I've cut those toes out. Going to go to my perspective view, select those vertices, and just expand my selection until I've got those toes. Yep, we've kind of selected both of those things there, but we can just sew them back on. Select that edge, and just move and sew. There we go. Okay, let's work on this segment of the foot, and let's see what we come up with if we try another unfold. Again, it may not turn out the way you want, but at least we flatten it out so that we can keep working with it. So that looks much better. Okay, it's flat. That's all we need to do, and just keep a mental note of where your joints are. So that's the toe segment of the UV. So that means when we split the toes up, we just need to put it side by side, and the soles of the feet will sort of work with that as well. Just trying to find the edges, so that's kind of where it is. Okay, that's all right. All right, so for the toes, same deal as the fingers we did on the hand. We need to separate them into individual pieces. And it might be a little bit tricky to get those edges, but just go to your mesh view and select those edges there. Remember, there are only four toes here. This is not realistic to the physiology of bipeds, but it's not too bad. Not many people are going to notice, especially in a low poly model like this. Okay, we make that cut. Alright, now next thing I want to do is select these top vertices. I might actually select just one each, and let the computer try to figure it out. There are other UV mapping applications out there that can do this for you, so don't be afraid to use them if you have them. Whatever makes it easier. Basically, what I'm doing here is just using Maya to achieve that. If you have a faster way of doing it, then take that path for sure. Okay, and what I'm going to do is now separate them, move them apart. Oops. Okay, that's the pinky toe. This is the ring toe. That's the ring toe. The index toe, at least that's what I think it's called, the index toe. That's the ring toe there. This is the pinky toe right here. Okay, pinky toe is a little bit tiny. So I'm going to just scale them up so that it matches. And the reason is because, again, the computer couldn't figure out what size or scale it is, so I'm just trying to keep this consistent. So those are our toes. And in the fingers, I actually made some cuts over here to make that work, but because they're so strangely shaped, I'm going to actually leave it as it is for the moment. I may actually need to... You know what? Let's do that. Let's fix that in. You're thinking to yourself now, how in the world are you going to start painting on simple lines like this? Well, it's a combination of using Photoshop or a sculpting program. There are some aspects of painting or texturing your character that you can't actually do in Photoshop, or it's actually very cumbersome to do in Photoshop, so in some cases you have to use another program to pull that off. Okay, so that's looking good. Yeah, I'm just trying to identify where this pinky toe is going to be. Okay, so that's the top there. I'm going to just make the slices accordingly. Same deal here. And like magic, I'm going to select the top segment of those toes and then let the computer unfold it once more. So let's select them to pin those vertices there, or UV, and then unfold and see what we get. That's much cleaner, it's much easier to work with. I think I must have forgotten one segment of that. No, it's looking weird. I don't know why that's not working. That's because actually I didn't cut that segment. There we go. So I'm just trying to be consistent. Might size that down a little bit. Okay, so those are our toes. We've got the big toe right here, should technically be larger. Now you can see we're actually layering this out quite well. You can imagine you start painting on this, it will work really, really nicely. Just don't forget to have a very high res texture for this. I'm probably going to work in 4K for a couple of reasons. One, it's just going to be one single UV value, so I want them all on one image. It just makes it easy for us. I'm going to resize these feet. And let's take a look at our UV map. So it's looking quite good. It's quite consistent in terms of its size. Toes are not too bad. They're okay. They're not perfect, but again, like, I'm not trying to be fully detailed with the texturing on the toes. I just want it to work. Okay, so for the feet, I want it to be consistent with each other in terms of its size. So I'm going to use the grid and just pop two of these vertices there, and then use the unfold tool to try and get the computer to figure it out. Funny enough, I must have cut that segment as well. So we'll just select those edges and move and sew. Let's try that again. Unfold, looking great. So theoretically, that should be the same size. Okay, so that's our feet, or our legs done. Well, not really done, but we've laid it out so that we can at least work with it. Might move the soles of the feet down here, and then I'll work on the toes and start arranging them accordingly. So that's our feet torso complete. Let's move on to the next one, which will be, what will it be? The head. Yes, the three major components of the body. So for our head, again, messy UV. Let's start with a plane Z-axis, and that's our model. Let's move it to the side, just roughly get that right. For the head, we have to break this up a little bit differently because this is fairly complex. It's not your typical fingers that you can move around, but we're using the same principles basically. The best tip I can give you is to just try to find the most efficient way of putting your seams in. You want minimal seams, well, as minimal as possible, but you want to get most of this face, you know, having less seams if you can, because, you know, mirroring this halfway is, that's an easy way of doing it, but we're not trying to do that. We want this to be very versatile. So let's start by cutting open, or putting some edge, or just selecting that edge loop right there. And from here, I might actually cut all the way down here and then past that neck. I'll leave that neck intact. So cut down there. It's kind of just trying to make a decision on where you want this to go. I'm thinking I don't want that happening down there because I want this fur to be integrated in there as well. So what I'll do is I'm going to make it go behind the fur, behind that low poly fur. Just trying to find the most efficient way or efficient path for that curve to go. So go up, and it will continue behind the fur. Okay, and I'm going to make a cut and select that head and move that out of the way. That's the tricky part about this, is making good decisions for your seams. So we've got the head there. The other thing I want to separate is the interior of the mouth. And the seam that I want to make is on the inside of that mouth there, so that everything on the lips will be, you know, just a normal white color. And then inside the mouth, I actually can't see, you know, you have the red, and then the interior of the mouth will be sort of red, dark red. And then just make sure I've got everything. I'm going to make that cut there as well. Select that shell, move it out of the way. Okay, so we've got the face here, which is quite okay. It's not too bad. Let's select a couple of vertices, namely the ones over there, and just unfold to see what the computer comes up with. It's not going to be pretty. No, it's not pretty at all. So that's actually really, really bad. Okay. Which is fine. The main problem is because there are so many meshes that are just folding in and out of itself. It's going to make it really difficult for the computer to figure this out. So what we'll do, I'm going to temporarily cut those low poly fur out. Remember the low poly fur that we kept in? I'm just going to cut them out temporarily. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Do the same here. Which looks quite good. Make that slice. I'm gonna move that fur up. Okay, let's try again. Actually, the other problem is the back of the neck. That's because the seam is sort of open. So if I tried to unfold this now, it's still gonna be messed up. So we need to make that cut in the back of the head, or the back of the neck there. And there we go. So I'm sure that's where I'm just making a mental note to make sure I didn't go too far, which is good. I'm going to make that slice, and then hopefully this should bring this out. Oops. This should sort of help. Well, it's a little bit better. It's not perfect, so, which is okay. Let's try selecting one of these other vertices, and yeah, it's still having a little bit of trouble. What I'm doing is I'm selecting the back of the neck, just moving that away, because I think one of the things is the computer's struggling with just that back neck, probably. Let's try and do that. Yeah, it's a little bit better. I can select the whole mouth down here. That's much, much better. So sometimes you just gotta try different vertices to see what the computer can try and work on. I think it's most likely the lips that are messing that up, which is okay. It's not too bad in this particular case. I may make a couple of just a couple, actually select that interior mouth and go to UV. I'm going to just deselect, oops. Just deselect that, and I'm going to manually scale this in. Okay, just so that we've got a nice good spread. So you may have seen, you know, skins that look a little bit like this in other 3D, like say maybe a, I don't know, game or something. So that's basically what they do. They lay out the game, or they lay out the UV maps that look like this. And I'm going to keep trying to get a good balance between the features, because some of it can be a little bit out of whack. I'm going to select that again, and the lips. Just make sure I deselect some of those, and then unfold and try to get a good balance. Okay, and we're looking quite good. There's few distortions on the face, okay, which is good. That's what we're looking for. So that will work for the moment. I'm going to go edit, delete, non-deformer history. All right, let's move on to the fur. Remember the fur that we've released or moved away. I'm just going to select those two vertices and see what the computer comes up with. It's not very good in that case. So we're going to have to make a few cuts. And one of the main cuts I will work on is probably on the back. Okay, so the back seam, back bottom. You may be wondering, how do you know where to cut and where the computer will make a good unfold? Well, you don't really. It's a lot of guess and check, sorry, trial and error, and just trying to get the best result with the least number of editing. Least amount of editing if is possible. It's not always going to be perfect. In my case, I'm doing a lot of, you know, testing, just messing around with the seams to see what I can get out of it. Might unfold that once more and try again. I might have selected the wrong edge. And so that's going to work. Unfold in that direction. Might select that back one there as well. So I'll do the same for this. And cut. Alright, let's see what we come up with. Yeah, it's not too bad, it's a little bit better. I don't know where that stray one came from. Must have been problem there. Oh, that's right. I think I lost one of those edges. I'm going to quickly add an edge in there because that's actually messing around with some of our UVs, and those are triangles, and I know that. But because it's such a low poly model, there are some segments where I actually need to use triangles. That's a little bit better. I'm going to do the same for this side. I do not recommend doing this at this stage, guys. So anything like this should be sort of checked during your modeling stage. Yeah, there are some times when you can't really help it, and that's okay. But because I'm making these small, tiny changes, it's not going to affect our rig too badly. At least I hope not. So it's not bad etiquette or anything. It's just to help save you some pain when you're working on your texturing, because you don't want the rig to collapse at this stage. I've softened those edges, and let's try again and see how we go. What I'll do is I'll just leave that there for now, and until I figure out something that works well, I'm going to move on to the back of the head and the mouth, the interior of the mouth. It's going to be quite straightforward for this, so don't worry too much. Let's select the mouth again. And I'm going to go two UVs, deselect that front. and just unfold, and hopefully the computer will be able to figure something out. Now, this is the interior of the mouth. It's not a big deal because there's not going to be a lot of detail inside the mouth unless, you know, that's something that you want. But because it's going to be just a flat color, you know, in general, I'm just going to leave it like that because I can just flood that segment using like a flood tool in Photoshop. And for the back of the head, you can imagine we can do the same thing. We just select a couple and don't forget that there's just a lot of little things that are going to go wrong here, so just don't expect the best. So already we've got problems, and they're not too bad in terms of its layout. It's okay. Some segments could use a little bit of a tweak. Also remember that the back of the head here in this particular segment is very it's going to be very hairy or furry, so some distortions aren't too bad because you can actually disguise it using just basic textures. But the most important thing is the places where they're most visible. That's the one that those are the areas that you want to watch out for and make sure that there aren't distortions. What I'm going to do is select these bottom ones. It's kind of like if you've done leather skinning before, what they do is they try to lay out, you know, splay out the skin as much as possible to, you know, get as much detail as they can. That's kind of what we're doing here. Some segments will have more detail than the others. So if that's the case, I'm going to just keep them sort of just up there. So it's looking okay. It's not perfect as always, but it's looking okay. I just want to make sure I lose the overlap. So that segment down there is not bad if we get a lot of distortion because people won't actually be seeing that. We'll be disguising it with a lot of streaky textures. But that's the back of the head done. And I'm going to move on. I'm going to end this video for this segment and move on to the rest of that. And before I do that, I'm going to try and fix that hair up, and I might actually do that in the next video because this hair here is a little bit tricky to unfold, which is okay. It's just some of the areas that we've got to watch out for. So we've got all the major aspects done. So we've got the torso, the head, and the legs. Okay. All in all, that's about 80% complete for those segments. We're going to do more complex shapes like this one a little bit later, and we'll move on to some of the other body parts as well. Alright guys, see you in the next video.